So I get the question all the time, how do I have my developer workflow set up? And I thought I would take a moment and give you a tour day workflow of my setup. I go over the software that I use and why I use it. So I spend a good deal amount of time working on my developer workflow. I spend almost no time ricing my Linux experience, right? I just don't care about i3 gaps. I don't care about my color scheme in the terminal. I don't care if it's GPU rendered text or not. What I want is it to be fast reacting when I press a key. I want it to be able to have a nice configurable output so that I can have this uniform experience, and I want it to be able to get to where I want to go with as few keystrokes and mental overhead as possible. And I base a lot of this off of the fact that I used to play StarCraft. If you've never played StarCraft, effectively it's just a real-time strategy in which you need to be able to move from screen to screen, either working on your economy, moving your troops, having both the attack, the defense, and the economy all at the exact same time. Now, there is no splitting screens. You simply have to shortcut everything out and make it work. So I've mirrored my experience a lot in the time I used to play StarCraft, meaning that every single thing I have is going to be just like a simple keystroke away, and I'll be where I want to be. So let me show you how I accomplish that. If you're using a Mac OS, some of this won't apply to you, but most of it will. If you're using Windows, I don't know what to tell you other than may God have mercy on your soul. All right, so this is Ubuntu without, you know, window management, right? It's just like you got all your windows floating everywhere. You can use Alt-Tab to like cycle through your terminals, or you can launch this little quick launcher window, which allows you to see all your windows, and then you can visually look through all of them and select the one you want to go to. This is an awful experience. I mean, the amount of mental overhead just switching windows that you have to put into it is just excruciating. So let me show you a better way. So let me show you what it looks like using a window manager. So what I have for my window manager is every single workspace represents a single use item. So let me unmaximize. And if you look down here, you'll notice right away I have 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, and 7. So let me remaximize. There we go. I'm just in my terminal. So when I press Alt-3, I will always go to my work terminal. When I press Alt-2, I'll always go to my work browsing experience. So whatever I'm using to search up what I need to know during this development session, number one will always go to my like twitching, my kind of fun thing. I usually have it on my laptop monitor because I just want to watch whatever's happening over there. 4, mystery. I still don't know what to put on 4. 5 will be my Slack, which I can't show you. 6, I put GIMP on. And 7 is always my VPN. 9 is always kind of like my utility windows that I need to do various things to my desktop. Being able to put my key display down here, that kind of stuff. The reason why I have it set up that way is such that I can go anywhere whenever I need to go. So if I'm like, I need to go to my browser, I just do it. I don't have to think about it. I don't have to do any sort of mental overhead. I've been using the exact same setup for years now, to the point where it's just muscle memory. My spinal cord responds to my thinking. I don't have to do nothing, right? I'm just like, terminal, right? It goes right there. And this kind of mirrors that StarCraft play, right? You can set groups. You can jump to groups. I have my groups. I have my fun, my work, my terminal. Of course, my Slack. You can't see my sweet drawings, by the way. Look at that drawing. VPN and work stuff. And more. Really, and more. Lots of stuff. Now, if you're using Mac OS, I don't know if you get this one, okay? Like, I don't know. I think they have better touch tools and some other ones that you can kind of adjust it around, but they really just want you to experience the beautiful transitions and the wonder in which they've created. So you need to sit down and shut up and enjoy what you got, okay? I hope you enjoy drinking that Phil's coffee. For the rest of us neckbeards, we will continue to use superior management of screens using Linux. All right, so i3 obviously is just navigating between larger sets of tasks to do, right? I got my browsing, I got my terminals, Slack, VPN, etc. So now we're narrowed in just on the terminal. So there's two types of kind of navigation I need to be able to do. One, I need to go to places that I visit less often. I could use, say, a fuzzy finder to get there. Or two, go to places I visit all the time. I would expect a single keystroke to get there. So let me kind of show you how I solve those two applications. The first one is just fuzzy finding over all my work directories and all my personal directories. Whether I'm in Vim or I'm in the terminal, if I do Control F, it will bring up all my personal and all my work directories. Let's go to one that I don't visit very often, NRDJS, Netflix Ready Device JavaScript. All right, you get that, you see that. When I press enter, it will create a TMUX session with this in its window. And there we go, we've navigated to NRDJS, and I'm using TMUX kind of to keep this session alive. TMUX is a terminal multiplexer, which means that you can have a single view into many terminals. You can have multiple views into the same terminal. It allows you to be able to have sessions that last longer than your terminal. So if I put in a command, say AOEU, then ASDF, and then close this entire window, reopen up a terminal. Notice that I'm not in TMUX at all. And then I go TMUX attach. I'm right back to where I was. I've reattached to my previous session. TMUX is incredible. I'm not going to go over all the specifics in this video, but you should definitely check it out. And it works really well on both Mac and Linux. I don't know about when. I have no idea what happens on Windows other than I play Apex and Tarkov, which is like getting punched in the dick. But that's just fuzzy finding, right? I don't want to just kind of be stuck in there, right? I want to be able to keep on going and go even further. So there's projects I visit all the time. So let's go visit my personal project, Vim with me. If I do Control A, which is my entrance into TMUX commands, and then Shift first finger home row, my power finger, I press power finger, and I'll go to Vim with me in the TMUX session. When I look at my sessions, notice I have my EnerDJS session and my Vim with me session. That means this thing is a long-lived session. I didn't replace it. Instead, it's its own session. So that means if I'm in Vim and I decide to go to another one, say Harpoon, it will now open up Harpoon. If I navigate back to Vim with me, it'll be where it was. So I love being able to go exactly where I want to go with a single key press, or be able to fuzzy find my way to where I want to go on the less frequently visited places. This means I no longer have to CD around. I no longer have to manually create these TMUX sessions. I have just everything automated. The script is found down below. By the way, if you'd like 1,000 upvotes on a comment, just put like TMUX for the win, or tell me to use Alacrity, or tell me to use Kitty. Honestly, just put any of those comments down below and you'll just get thousands of likes, okay? I'm doing your job for you. So lastly, my development experience. So now we're at the most narrow point of development. I'm no longer even navigating around in terminals. I'm now navigating around in a code base. All right, so I have two different ones. I use Telescope, which is an FCF-like, very extensible fuzzy finder written by our very own Telescopic Johnson. Of course, just like any fuzzy finder, you know, you start typing, you get exactly what you want, you press enter, you'll jump right there. I don't really like the overhead of always using a fuzzy finder because often I'm working on anywhere between 2 to 4 main files, and then I'm using an LSP to jump around, and I always want to return to one of those 2 to 4 files with just a single key press. That is why I've developed a plugin called Harpoon. It allows you to do marks. It's a lot like kind of Vim marks, except for they update every time you leave. They persist, they're long running, and there's a couple extra options. They're easy to move around. If I wanted to swap the order, there we go. Order swapped. As you can see, Pobo is now number one, envelope is now number two. Let's put it back. You can see it's back. So if I just simply navigate to number two, I'll navigate to Pobo. That's all there is to it. All right, look at that. Awesome. This is fantastic. I can navigate to three. I can navigate to four with just a single key press. And often that's all I want, is I want to be able to have just specific things marked and jump as fast as possible. This has been a huge benefit in my productivity, and it just is really simple. The amount of overhead is rather small. This is what my workflow looks like today, but it may look a lot different in the future. So obviously I didn't go into a ton of depth. There's obviously a ton of configuration that is needed to get to this point. I have all the scripts linked down below. It is in my .files repo, all of this. But ultimately, in the end, what I have focused on, instead of making Linux look pretty, I've made it exceptionally functional and exactly the way I want it, which is like the real big selling point to Linux. I just want to be able to do what I want to do with the lowest amount of overhead and the swiftest speed. It just feels right. And ultimately, I'm just playing StarCraft every single day, and it's fantastic. If you like what you see, hey, I developed almost everything so far on Twitch, and we have a thriving Discord community. All the links down below. I hope to see you there. It's a moderately not appropriate for work fun time.